For every woman who ever thinks she isn't enough or constantly questions her ability, know that you are more than enough and beyond capable. Walk boldly in your purpose and trust your gifts. Be confident, even in doubt. Trust that what God has for you is for you. Sis, you are beautiful. You are deserving. You are special, and you can do it. So today is interview day. It is March 19th, and my interview will start at 3:40. I'm so excited. I'm a little bit nervous, but I'm ready to show everyone why I think I deserve to be the next Miss WSSU.
Miss WSSU definitely would be what I stated in the interview when someone asks, what are you looking for in a Miss WSSU? Somebody who's involved in the community, socially aware of what's going on, not just in East Forsyth, but also around the United States. And how can we band together to make sure that a Miss WSSU is not seen as a ceremonial or a pageantry type of role, where you're actually doing the work that impacts the people, not just on your campus, but worldwide. So that's what I really want to see in a Miss WSSU. Someone who's modern, knows how to speak well, eloquent, but also knows how to roll up her sleeves and actually get the work done.
I'm just so proud of her. She has, her whole career here at WSSU has been about living the legacy, because she is a third to fourth generation Ram. And so she's heard those stories all the years, and she's committed to living up to what her foremothers and fathers have done. And she's always been poised with purpose. And so I can tell you, this is not just a platform for Taylor. When she says it's a lifestyle, it's a lifestyle. And as her mother, I couldn't be more proud.
I love my H and for my B. My B is for my C. I love my HBCU. I love my H in front of my B, my B in front of my C. I love my HBCU. When operating as the true kings and queens we historically are, to be mediocre is not an option. Ladies and gentlemen, it is time to set a standard. It is time to be the standard. It is time to refine our reign. Good evening, Ram family. I am Taylor Alexandria Walker, a junior mass communications major, speech minor, bringing you love and greetings from the Durham, North Carolina. And I am here today to encourage you to live the legacy while remaining poised with purpose. But don't you forget, always regal and real. A vote for royalty is a vote for representation. A vote for royalty is a vote for elegance, class, and style. See, a vote for royalty is a vote for you. So vote Taylor Alexandria Walker as your AD, Miss Winston-Salem State.
Taylor, I am so proud of you as your father. I have watched you grow and mature into a beautiful young lady. And my fondest wish for you is that you will continue to serve this university, serve the students, and give them your very best. They deserve no less.
My advice to Taylor would be to stay true to herself no matter what. A lot of times as queen, you're gonna come in encounters with criticism from everybody in every corner, but you just have to stay true and authentic to who you are.
Taylor is to just lead with your heart, continue being the genuine, happy, bubbly person that she is now, and just serve the people, be for the people, which I know she already is.
Stay humble, stay true to yourself, and always believe in the possibilities.
I would say be the same person you have been for the past 3 years. That's matter the most. That was your campaign, and that should continue to be your campaign.
I would just tell her to be true to herself. I love her, like her personality, her vibe, like everything she stands for. I didn't have a class with her, nothing like that. We just started talking off her personality. So I would just tell her to stay herself, like make true to herself.
Good evening, Ram family. I just wanted to, before I sing, I wanted to say one thing I'm learning while being royalty and refining the way is that you have to show up even in spite of. So tonight you probably can hear that I'm struggling with my voice. I actually lost it, but I think it's ironic that I'm singing a song I'm here, because in spite of losing my voice, I'm here to sing for you guys, and I'm here to perform. Thank you.
Our deepest fear is not that we are inadequate. Our deepest fear is that we are powerful beyond measure. It is our light, not our darkness, that most frightens us. We ask ourselves, who am I to be brilliant, gorgeous, talented, fabulous? Actually, who are you not to be? You are a child of God. Your playing small does not serve the world. There's nothing enlightened about shrinking so that other people won't feel insecure around you. We are all meant to shine as children do. We were born to make manifest to the glory of God that is within us. It is not just in some of us, it is in everyone. And as we let our own light shine, We unconsciously give other people permission to do the same. As we're liberated from our own fear, our presence automatically liberates others.